Hello to everyone, myself Dipendra Singh, and today we are going to see part 2 of exercise 1.3, and this video is basically based on the word problem only, means last 5 questions of this exercise based on word problem that we are going to see. And if you have not seen my previous video on the same exercise, you can go in the playlist and you can check my previous video and you can see over there. Okay, let's see. Question number 6, a certain freezing process. See, in today's videos, all question will be based on word problem. So in word problem, there are certain rules. And what is the rule? Rule is that you have to read the question at least twice. Two times at least you have to read the question, so that you will get all the things what question is saying. Right? So we are going to read it. A certain freezing process requires that room temperature be lowered from 40 degrees Celsius at the rate of 5 degrees Celsius. One word they have mentioned, lowered. Lowered means lower, decrease, death, these all, and loss, these all word basically indicating to minus sign. Okay, we will see in the solution how we are going to implement it. And another part of the question, what will be the room temperature 10 hours after the process begins? So let's see answer. So initial temperature, it was 40 degrees Celsius. Now we will apply over here unitary law. Unitary law that you used to learn from 5th class onwards. Means for 1 hour, minus 5 degrees Celsius. So for 10 hours, so simply we'll multiply. And it will come minus 50 degrees Celsius, right? And finally, we will combine them up. And how to combine? By adding them, right? By adding them. And minus another number is minus number, means negative number. And we will write into the bracket only. So 40 degrees Celsius plus in bracket minus 50 degrees Celsius. So it will come minus 10 degrees Celsius. I think you got the concept of this question. We applied over here unitary law. And then we have combined initial and final temperature and we got the answer. Let's see question number 7, right? And this question is having basically 3 parts. We will see one by one, and for all parts instructions are same. And what is the instruction? In a class test containing 10 questions and 5 questions for the correct answer and minus 2 for the incorrect answer and 0 for the not attempted, right? So we will see the first condition, means first case we will see. Mohan gets 4 correct and 6 incorrect. For correct, how much marks you will be awarded? By 5 marks. So these all things we have to memorize it. That is why I told you, you must read word problem at least thrice you can read the question, so that you will get all the things what question is saying to you. Okay, so here basically Mohan gets 4 correct, 6 incorrect. What will be final score? So let's see answer. So here also we are going to apply unitary law only, right? Means for one correct answer, 5 marks. So for 4 correct answer, we'll multiply unitary law. And now for the wrong answer, we'll also implement unitary law only. Means for one wrong answer, minus 2. Then for 6, we'll multiply minus 2 into 6. And answer will come minus 12. And now finally, we'll combine them up. Because we have to calculate, you know, final marks and score obtained by Mohan. So we will combine them up and answer will come. Okay. Let's see another case of the same question. And another case is Reshma gets how much? 5. Incorrect answer and 5 correct answer. What is her score? Means 5 correct answers and 5 incorrect answers. So what will be her score? Again, we will apply only unitary law. We will apply unitary law for correct questions and we will apply unitary law for incorrect answers, and finally we will combine them up. Very easy. Unitary law over here, unitary law over here, and then we will combine them up. Unitary law means one correct answer, 5 marks. Then for 5 correct answer, so 5 5s are 25. Okay, for incorrect, for 1 incorrect, minus 2. And for 5 incorrect, so minus 5 into 2. And you can say minus 2 into 5 and it will come minus 10. And in last, we will combine them up. And once we'll combine and we will get the answer. Let's see another case of the same question. And the third part of the same question is, Hina gets 2 correct and 5 incorrect answer out of 7 questions she attempt, right? What is her score? Let's see answer. So again, we will apply unitary law for correct answer and unitary law for incorrect answer. And finally, we will combine them up. The same thing we were doing in the previous question. So marks given for 2 correct answers, 5 twos are 10. And marks given for 5 wrong answers, right? So minus 2 into 5. Minus 2 into 5. It will come minus 10. And then we will combine them up. Once we'll combine, so answer will come 0. Means Hina. Hina will get 0 marks. I hope you are getting it. Means we had applied unitary law. Here we have not written in very detail because in last two parts we have seen how we are applying unitary law. Here I have written directly marks obtained by 2 correct answers, 5 twos are 10, and for wrong answer, minus 5 into minus 2 into 5, and it will get minus 10. And then finally we will combine them up. Let's see another question. So another question, and this question is also having several parts, but condition are different, but in starting question is given to you, a cement company earns a profit of rupees 8 per bag for white cement, remember students, white cement sold, and a loss, and loss is always indicating to minus sign. Profit is always indicated to positive sign. So these are something you have to memorize it also, and you have to keep in mind also. So, and a loss of rupees 5 per kg which bag? Gray cement bag, right? Okay, so we will see the first condition. Again, I am telling you, at least you have to read the question twice or thrice. Okay, let's see first question. Cement company sells 3000 bags white cement and 5000 bags gray cement, right? Again, we will apply over here only and only unitary law. Let's see how. So profit is denoted by a positive number that I told you before that, right? And loss is denoted by a negative integers. So the first part we are going to solve, that is A part. So profit earned while means for one bag, again we are going to apply unitary law only that I told you. For one bag, 8 rupees that you were given the question only, 8 rupees, right? So for one bag, 8 rupees. So for 3000 bag, how much? 8 into 3000, it will come 24,000, right? And the same unitary law we will apply for the gray bags also. So gray cement actually. So for one bag, minus 5, and then for 5000, so we will multiply, and minus 25,000 will come, and finally we will combine them. Same thing we were doing in the previous question also, right? So here also we are doing the same. For profit, unitary law. For loss, unitary law. Then in the last we will combine them up. That's all. So after combining, answer will come minus 1000. How much it will come? Minus 1000. And again, this minus sign is indicating that company is facing loss. Therefore, a loss of rupees 1000 will be incurred by the company. Let's see another part of the same question. And another part is, what is the number of cement bag it sells? Dekho, starting mein hi inhone pooch liya hai question. What is the number of white cells? Means this number of white bags you have to find over here, right? Okay. Let's read another part of the question. It must sell to have neither profit. This condition is also very important. Neither profit nor loss. Right? It means if I'll add profit and loss, so as a result, I'll get 0. Okay, if the number of gray bags sold is 6400, so you are given the number of gray bags, but you are not given number of white bags, that you have to find. Okay, so let's see answer. So loss incurred while selling one gray bag minus 5 means for one bag minus 5. So for 6400 bags, simply you multiply, means we have applied over here unitary law. It's very simple. Okay, so after applying unitary law, minus 5 into 6400, I'll get as a result minus 32,000. Okay, again we are going to see another part of the question. Let the number of, because we don't know the number of cement bags, which cement bag, white cement bags, we don't know, right? That we have to calculate. So here we are going to consider it. What we are going to consider it? Let the number of bags of white cement to be sold be X. X is a variable that we have considered as white cement bags, right? So again we are going to write the another instruction of the question. Profit earned while selling one bag of white cement is equal to 8 rupees. That we know from here, 8 rupees यहाँ पे प्रॉफिट होता है जब एक व्हाइट सीमेंट का बैग ही बेचते हैं, ठीक है? सो वी विल अप्लाई यूनिटरी लॉ, मींस फॉर वन बैग 8 रुपीज, देन फॉर एक्स बैग्स 8 × x, यूनिटरी लॉ सिंपल. फॉर वन व्हाइट बैग, फॉर वन व्हाइट सीमेंट बैग 8 रुपीज, देन फॉर एक्स व्हाइट सीमेंट बैग इट विल बी 8x. ओके, एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द क्वेश्चन, इन द क्वेश्चन इट वॉज क्लियरली मेंशन दैट नो प्रॉफिट एंड no loss, right? And when this type of condition is there, so it means profit plus loss, it will always equal to zero, right? So same thing we are going to do over here. Profit earned plus loss incurred is equal to zero, because it is clearly mentioned in the question that there is no profit and no loss. It means profit plus loss will be zero. Okay, so 8x was the profit and plus minus 32,000 was loss, right? So that we have combined it and equal to, we have, you know, put a zero, right? And here one more rule of calculation part, that is minus 32,000. It is in this side. If I'll send minus 32,000 into another side, so it will become plus. So there are some rules while you are sending one number from one side to another side. So what are the rule? Rule is, means plus will always change to minus, minus will always change to plus, and multiplication will always change to divide sign, and divide sign will always change to multiplication, right? So here number is negative. So once it will go another side, so sign will be changed and minus will become plus. As I told you over here, means minus sign will change into plus. So that is why it has changed. Okay, so 32,000 I have written. Now 8x is equal to 32,000. Now I have to find the value of x, not 8x. We have to find the value of x only. So with x, you can see over here ki 8 jo hai saath mein laga hua, 8 laga hua hai. So anyhow, I have to send 8 into another side. And you can see over here, 8 is basically engaged with x with multiply sign. With multiply sign. So if it is multiplied sign, then it will go another side. It will come in upon only. As I told you in the rule, what was the rule? That multiplication will be changed into divide sign. Multiplication will change into divide sign, right? So it was engaged with x with multiplication sign. Once it will go into another side, it will come in upon. So 32,000 upon it. So 8 fours are 32. So 4,000 will come as a answer. So what is the value of x? That is 4,000. And what was the x? X was basically, it was basically white bag cement. Okay, so therefore 4,000 bags of white cement must be sold in order to make no profit and no loss. Let's see another question. So this type of question, how to solve this type of question? So I am telling you certain rule. You have to follow basically two rule. The first rule is, first you have to check the sign. And the second rule is, you know what is the second rule? Then you have to guess the number. So there are two rules that you have to follow, rule one and rule two. First you have to guess the sign, then second rule you have to guess the number. Okay, let's see. First question, minus 3 into something that we don't know, that we have to fill, is equal to 27. So can you guess the sign of the number? In the rule I told you only, first you have to guess the sign, then the second rule is, then you have to guess the number. So first you have to guess the sign, means what will be the sign? You can see over here, 27 is a positive number, minus 3 is a negative number. So it's very simple that this number will also be a negative number, right? Because negative negative will be multiplied and it will come a positive number. Okay, so we have guessed the sign, right? Now another step is now you have to guess the number. Means now you can see ki by which number I'll multiply to 3 so that I'll get 27. It's very simple that the number will be 9. Right? Number will be 9. So 9 3 is a 27. So I hope you are getting it. You have to follow the step. The step one is, first you have to guess the sign. Then another rule is you have to guess the number. So we guess the sign first, then we guess the number first. The same thing we are going to do over here. So 5 into something is equal to minus 35. So what will be the sign of this number that we have to fill? Sign will be negative, right? First we have to guess the sign only. Why it will be negative? Because we can see over here, one number is positive and into something is equal to minus 35. If here it is coming minus, then this number has to be minus number, okay? Negative number, okay? So first rule we have finished. Now apply the second rule. Second rule is guess the number. So we can see over here, by which number I'll multiply so that I'll get 35. So it will be 7. 7 5s are 35. It's very simple. Let's see another part. And another part is minus 8. By which number I'll multiply to minus 8, it will come minus 56. So first we have to see the rule 1. Rule 1 means we have to guess the sign of number. So of course it will be positive only, because something into minus is equal to minus 56. So result is coming minus. Result is coming minus means one number has to be positive and one number has to be negative. So this number is negative already, right? This number is negative already. So basically I'll multiply and I'll get minus 56. So now second rule is you have to guess the number. So it will be 7, right? It will be 7. Okay, let's see another part. Again, minus 12 and something is equal to 132. So it's very simple that we'll apply the first rule, and the rule one is you have to guess the sign. And what is the sign of this number? And it will be a negative number, because negative into negative will be positive, right? So the second rule is we have to guess the number. So it will be 11. It will be 11. So 11 into 12 will be 132. Okay, let's see answer now. So you can see over here, fill in the blanks. I have filled over here also. Minus 3 into minus 9 is equal to 27. 5 into minus 7 is equal to minus 35. 7 into minus 8, it will be minus 56. Minus 11 into minus 12 is equal to 135. Okay.